Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm talking to you about solar panels. Before we get too far into it, I am going to go ahead and give these a good clean because we've had them up here for about a year and a half now and they are pretty filthy. I've noticed a bit of a decrease on how much power we're getting, so I'm gonna go ahead and give these a good clean and we'll get into the review. If you haven't already checked out my solar guide, I would highly recommend you do so. I've sold over 100 guides so far and I've got really positive feedback about everyone I've sold. So if you want to check that out, head over, click that link below the video or up in the corner and feel free to let me know if you have any questions. When I was planning out our solar system, I was really stressed about how many watts we were going to have for the system itself, and I really wanted to make sure we had enough power since it's really important for me and Kaylee while working on the road to make sure that we can charge our laptops, the camera, the drone, and not have to worry about how much storage we have. So I was very stressed about having enough watts. Right here, I have three of the Renogy 175 watt rigid solar panels. They have performed really well ever since we've had them. I haven't had any problems with them. But one of the things that I wanted to talk to you guys about was the fact that I haven't relied on them as much as I thought I could. So with that said, solar is a really nice feature to have, but I think there's some more important features when it comes to roof space that I think you should consider. For me and Kaylee, that was having a really big skylight and then also the roof fan. I've seen lots of vans out there that have cargo carriers on the roof as well. Plan out everything you need to have on your roof and then try to fit as many solar panels as you can, because chances are your main power supply is actually going to be your vehicle's alternator. That's what ours is, and if we do run low on power, we usually end up plugging into shore power or even a generator if we absolutely have to. So with the solar panel during the summer months, it's really nice. We can pull about 30 amps an hour if we're getting full sun, and that will charge our 200 amp hour battery super quickly. But when we're parked in campgrounds or during the winter time when we're only getting maybe 5 to 6 hours a day, we might only get like 5 amps an hour because the sun is so low in the sky that we can't rely on the solar panels. My advice to you would be to get as many roof fans as you want, skylights, cargo holders, anything you think you need on your van's roof, and then fill out the rest of the space with solar panels. In total, we're pulling about 540 watts of solar and about 30 amps at full capacity. Now that is honestly quite a bit of solar, and one of the questions I get asked most is how much solar do we actually need? And that is pretty much my answer, is as much as you have room for would be great. When it comes to choosing solar panels, about 200 watts seems to be about the largest size that you can get, but they do vary a lot and you can get more than one. I would try to get one solar panel as big as possible. That way you don't have to use a lot of connections and you don't have to worry about wiring them in parallel or series. Mine are wired in parallel, and that is because I have the Renogy 50 amp DC to DC charger with MPPT. It has a maximum input voltage of 25 volts. So the difference between wiring them in parallel versus series is series keeps the voltage the same and increases your amperage. So mine is going to be 10 amps plus 10 amps plus 10 amps up to 30 amps. But the voltage is gonna stay the same. If I had wired these in series, the voltage would have increased and the amps would have stayed the same. So I would have only been pulling about 10 amps, but the voltage would have gone up. These solar panels are about $200 each Canadian, and they are the rigid ones. They aren't the soft ones. The soft ones are gonna be quite a bit more expensive and a little bit harder to mount. I know, depending on your application, if you have a flat surface, they'll be really easy to mount, but with most vans, especially the Sprinter T1Ns, they have these ribs that go along the top, which would make mounting anything flat very difficult. How I mounted my solar panels was actually fairly simple. I purchased some Unistrut that runs the length of the solar panels on both sides. And then I used a rivet gun to rivet and bolt the Unistrut down to the roof of the van. And I bolted it where the ribs are to make it super strong. I used M8 bolts, I believe, and I sealed them off as well. That basically gave me two roof rails that I was able to mount the solar panels to. And then I picked up some aluminum angle and cut small pieces and mounted them right to the Unistrut using bolts and washers. That they are a little bit flexible. I can kind of move them around as I need to, and they're not permanently mounted to the van. I also limited the amount of holes that I had to drill in the roof to 8. So that was kind of nice. I don't have 10 holes per panel. If you use the Renogy brackets, you'll be drilling a lot more holes to mount your solar panels. You can also see right here is the edge of my roof gland, which I will link in the description below off Amazon. I think this is around $20-$25. It was fairly inexpensive, but because I mounted mine here, I did have to cut around the outside of the solar panel, but I should have a clip to be able to show you guys what's going on there. And then you can see right there how I've set up this. So I have 4 brackets holding the solar panels to the Unistrut, and then I've also bolted the panels together in the middle with 4 bolts basically just going in between each panel, holding them together. Be sure to throw lock washers on everything and even some Loctite on the threads. Make sure you really don't want this coming loose. As far as mounting the roof gland, I would recommend using the Sika Flex. It's a really, really strong, durable sealant that works really well. It's designed for RV roofs. I will link that below in the description as well. After I used 4 brackets to bolt down each corner, I did have a little play in the middle here. So I did kind of custom make a bit of a bracket here and then just use 2 bolts, bolt it down, and it is very, very strong. I've been driving through some pretty heavy windstorms and this has never rattled or come loose, not even close. So it's really solid. It's a little tougher to access, but you can see there is a bolt over there and there is a bolt right here. It's just kind of a custom made Z bracket, you could call it, or an S bracket that worked pretty well. I just picked up some metal from a hardware store and bent it at the distances I needed to mount it. So all in all, this is a very affordable way to mount your solar panels on your van without putting a lot of holes in your roof. And these are also very customizable. If I want to take one off, I can pop it off and then just slide the brackets down essentially on the Unistruts. Yeah, if you have any questions regarding this system, feel free to let me know in the comments below. And definitely check out my solar guide. It was very useful for a lot of people out there, and I'm sure it'll be useful for you as well if you're a beginner. When it comes to wiring the solar panels, I would just pre-purchase Renogy's 10 gauge MC4 connectors. I believe it's 10 feet of wire, and that'll be able to handle more than enough for your solar panels. It's more than enough for me, it works really well. And those MC4 connectors also very handy. I also have 2 of the branch connectors to make sure that I can hook up all of them in parallel, and that made everything on the roof waterproof and sealed, and something that I don't have to worry about. Another important thing to mention about wiring your solar panels is fusing them. So you're gonna wanna use, in my case, these have a maximum current of 10 amps. So I put a 15 amp fuse for each solar panel on the positive wire. The reason why you do that is because if one of these panels go and it is not fused, that electrical current is going to go to the weakest and easiest place. So it's gonna flow towards that broken solar panel, and then you're basically gonna lose all of your power from your solar panels and you're not gonna know where that break is. So be sure to fuse each solar panel individually and do that by 1.5 times the maximum amperage is usually what you want to do. They also have a fuse rating that you can look up online. So yeah, I use 15 amp MC4 fuses that I can easily access if I need to. I also just want to apologize. The roof doesn't look so good right now. You can see kind of primer sprayed in areas. I did a bunch of rust treatment last summer, and I also Raptor lined the outside of our van, which I'll be making a video on, so be sure to check that out. It turned out quite well. I'm happy with it, but I only Raptor lined up to the drip catcher, the rain gutter here, mostly because I couldn't get enough Raptor liner for the roof, so I had to do this part and down. Our distributor didn't have enough in stock, so I had to wait until this summer, and I'm going to be taking everything off the panels and stuff, and then I'm going to be coating the whole roof with the white Raptor liner. So that should clean things up and make things look a little bit better. One more thing I wanted to add in there is me and Kaylee have seriously been debating getting a ladder for the outside of the van. I was just climbing up and down trying to record this video. So if you guys have any suggestions on ladders that we should consider buying, let us know in the comments below. We wanted to stay away from it for a while because I wasn't too sure if it was really necessary since we aren't storing anything on our roof. And we also wanted to do somewhat a low profile. I know our van looks like a camper van. It's got the window on the side, but I feel like a ladder is just that extra thing telling everyone that you are a camper van. So if you have any suggestions and you think we should install the ladder, comment below, let me know. That's it for me, guys. Be sure to like this video if you liked it, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next one.